In the wake of Japan's historic earthquake and tsunami, amid the devastation, the loss, an unexpected twist in matters of the heart, Yoko, a 49-year-old makeup artist, is applying with a matchmaking service for the very first time to find a husband. The disaster taught her she does not want to be alone.
So does that mean that you feel that life is shorter?
Absolutely, she says. Up until now, I've been devoted to work, but it's time to focus on my life. I need to act now before another disaster. Matchmaker Miyuki Uekusa says Yoko isn't her only client. She's seen a 30% jump in business since the tsunami and nuclear crisis.
Does this surprise you? Is this something that you were expecting?
I didn't expect it, she says, but the members of my matchmaking service all felt the same fear that they could die. Seeing the sad images on television reminded them of the importance of having a partner in life.
It's not just people who want to get married, it's also people actually getting married. Multiple vendors in the wedding industry are reporting a boost in business as well.
A 15 to 20% jump in ring buyers, says this wedding and engagement ring jewelry shop. In demand, custom rings, says this jeweler. After the quake, he says, couples want to create something that commemorates their relationship, that they make and hold forever. Bride Maki Maruta, trying out her dress for her wedding next month, says she'll walk down the aisle and into her marriage with a new sense of purpose. The disaster reminded me of the importance of family, she says. It's so important to have someone who is precious to you. Japan's historic disaster, there is no answer to the question why. But the country's people are learning they can at least control how they live and how to seek comfort in each other. Kyung Lah, CNN, Tokyo.